But first, we are learning new details tonight about how the Sweetwater Union School District plans to climb out of a $42 million hole.
Well, the district vowed not to start cutting teachers. Instead, 10 News anchor Vanessa Van Hefty found out it's dozens of administrators who could pay the price with their jobs. Vanessa.
Yeah, the district facing a real money mess. It is inside the boardroom here behind me, hashing out some of those details. Of those 87 positions, most are assistant principals who were given pink slips this afternoon.
It's just one sad story, frankly, because it's real people involved here, not just numbers.
Nick Marinovich says the writing has been on the wall.
Oh, the lack of processes and procedures and record keeping and all that had been going on for years, and finally it appeared it caught up with them this year.
The board in hot water needs to trim $42 million from the budget next year. Its answer in part, 87 employees pink slipped today.
Now, there's real people involved, and everything that I read is it's going to take quite a while to get out of the mess.
Not all 87 will get the axe. In a written statement, the district says the employees may be released or reassigned from their position. 69 of those positions are assistant principals, 5 are school psychologists, and 13 are office administrators. This longtime community advocate blames this audit and budget committee taking pointed jabs at the people she says contributed to the money mess.
Ms. Hall, you need to stop bragging about your financial analysis prowess. The deficit, alleged fraud, the investigations in county are proving you have none. A question that needs to be answered: why did you fail to provide fiscal accountability and oversight? Was that the plan all along?
A state fiscal agency accused the district of not being transparent. Sweetwater faces an investigation by the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission for allegedly lying about shortfalls. It also faces a state audit for potential fraud. The debacle has forced the county to step in to oversee the school board's decisions.
And the district will release its full report at next Monday's board meeting. But at this point, no teaching positions will be cut. Reporting live from Chula Vista, Vanessa Van Hefty, 10 News.
Thanks.